So yeah, hi, hello everybody. My name is Ritu, and I'll be teaching you social science. So yeah, in the last video, you guys must have seen that how I have taught civics, and now we shall move towards history. Now, first of all, before I shall begin with what is history or you know the other questions like that, you must remember one thing: without history, we could never really know about what our today could possibly look like, or you know what our future could possibly look like. So you always must remember that history is something which connects us from the past to the future, and that's how it goes on, right? So yeah, that's how history goes on. Now in this first chapter, you guys must have seen how Babur has described India about this, you know, this wide spectrum of flora and fauna that we are blessed with, and how Minhaj-e-Siraj talked about India. He considered India only means Punjab, Haryana, you know, Delhi, the places like that only. So yeah, in this chapter we shall get to know about what was this whole advent of Islam in the country. You guys must understand one thing, that medieval India is actually more about how the Sultanate came in, right? What Mughals did, okay, and how Rajput rose to power. So that is what more like about the medieval India, right? But when we move forward, we realize the fact that somehow it was also a blessing for the mixing of two cultures, Hindu and Muslim. So realize the fact that due to that thing, we have got this beautiful composite culture where we could definitely talk about how Hindu Muslims, you know, mixed, they intermingled and talked about everything. Okay, so yeah, in this chapter, first thing is we must understand how these, you know, these chroniclers. Now, who are chroniclers? Chroniclers are generally more the people who talk about, you know, their books and everything, who make really books on how the time was and how the people was, what history looked like at that point of time. Okay, so that is basically, yeah. When Minhaj-e-Siraj and Ziauddin Barni, you guys must have heard his name, he's a very very important chronicler. When Ziauddin Barni explained about, you know, what India looked like, so they all had different ideas, different perspectives related to India, right? So what happens that after that, like after Ziauddin Barni, Minhaj-e-Siraj, Babur's Babur Nama, then Akbar's book, okay, and even if you know, like Akbar's Ain-e-Akbari and many other books, many other people who wrote several things. Like you must have heard one very important name Ziauddin Barni. He has written Tariq-e-Firozshahi, in which he has written that, you know, what was the chronology and how history looked like, and that.